Hello friends, in last video we have seen the stud overview, architecture, configuration. Today we'll see the remaining point from stud 2. We'll start with the actions. Actions are the core of stud 2 framework. In action, each URL is mapped to a specific action which provides the processing logic which is necessary to service the request from the user. Means whenever any request is coming from client or user, for every request, one specific action is mapped for that request. Example, if you see here, we have created a different action. In the left side, you will see there are 5 different actions: success, none, error, input and login. So depend on user input, some action is being called. The next is the interceptors. Interceptors allows for cross-cutting functionality to be implemented separately from action as well as framework. That means interceptors are used to achieve 3 things. First is provide pre-processing logic before the action is called. Next, provide the post-processing logic after the action is called. And third, catch the exception so that alternate processing can be performed. So basically 3 types of interceptors are there. One, used for pre-processing logic. Second is for post-processing logic, and third is to catch the exceptions. The examples of include exception handling, file uploading, lifecycle callbacks. These are some examples of interceptors. Few important interceptors in stud 2 are as, first is alias. It allows parameter to have different name alias across the request. Second is a checkbox, where with a checkbox you can attach false value if it is not checked and true value if it is checked. Third is I18N. It is used for finding or selecting the location for user session. Example, while you are using Google search, you can click as English, Marathi, Hindi. So whatever the location you click, the result is converted into that language. Third is exception. It maps the exception that are thrown from the action as a result. That means it allows the automatic exception handling via redirection. Next is file upload. It is used for the easy file uploading. Next is params. It is used to set the request parameter on the actions. Next is prepare. This is typically used to do pre-processing work, such as example like set up the database connections. Like before coding, you want that your database connection should be set up. Then next are the timers, where you are providing or information in the form of how long the action take to execute. Like if you're downloading a file, it will show you that 1 minute is required or 1 minute is remaining to download the file. Likewise, there are many interceptors are available. If you see how to create an interceptors, so for creating an interceptors in stud.xml file, you have to add the interceptors by using a tag interceptor/-ref and the name of the interceptor you are using. Like here, there are 2 examples. One is for param and second is for timer. So these 2 interceptors we have added in the stud.xml file. Likewise, you can also create a custom interceptor. So for creating any custom interceptors, you require to write 3 different functions like in servlet lifecycle, init method, then destroy method, and third method is a intercept method. In intercept method, you have to provide a parameter action innovation object. Just see the example given in a next to this slide. This one example. The next is the result types. So whenever any request is generated by client, some result is provided by stud2. So there are different result or results types, and they plays the role of view in the stud2 MVC framework, and it can be added using a result or results tag. For example, if action method is to authenticate a user, if you have created a login page and you have to authenticate a user, so there can be possibly three outcomes. That means three results. One can be successful login. Second result can be unsuccessful login with incorrect username and password. And third can be the account locked if more than three times he attempted for a unsuccessful login. So this is a simple example what kind of results you are going to show to the user when some action is being performed. Then stud comes with a number of predefined result types like dispatcher, velocity, freemaker, redirect, XSLT, etc. So if you talk about the dispatcher result type, so in dispatcher result type, where you give a result in the form of forwarding a request from one page to another page using a method request dispatcher dot forward method. So if you see this code, it indicates when in authentication, if the result is success, means username and password is right, then you have to forward the user request to the next page, that is helloworld.jsp. Likewise, there is a second example is a FreeMaker result type, which is very popular templating engine and used to generate output using predefined template. So here are some predefined templates are available, and for that predefined template, you are just providing some file or parameter. You are just passing, if you see here, we have passed here the parameter as a name. The next is a redirect result type. So here in redirect, you can use a method like response.sendRedirect. So when a user success in authentication, so we are giving the location where the user is going to redirect. So after successful, the user is going to redirect to the newworld.jsp file. Next is the validations. So whenever you are creating any of the application, the validations are very important. It plays a vital role. At the stud core, the validation framework that assists the application to run the rules to perform validation before action method is executed. Means, example, if you have created one registration form where an employee has to fill some information and you want certain field should have a value between some range. Example, in employee, you want that the age field should have the value in integer and the range should be between 28 and 65. If the value is below 28 or above 65, an automatic error should be error message should be generated. So that is an example of validation. So here one index.jpg file is created where you see that we have created one text box with the name age, and when user click on the submit button, this value is being checked by the validate function where it just checks that if age is less than 28 or age is greater than 85, one error message is added to that age field. The name is age field. The message is age must be in between 28 and 65. So you can add any validations to the text box, like if you want that your name should have only the character values or mobile number should have only the digit values, etc. So such kind of validations are possible using the validations in STIRPS. Next is a localization. The localization is possible using the internationalization, that is I-18N. Why the name as I-18N? Because the word internationalization start with I and end with N, and in between they have the 18 characters. So internationalization is abbreviated as A-18N, and it is being supported by using through the resource bundles, interceptors. So example, like I just show you first the output so you can understand the concept. Here, if you see the first screen, here select locate. In that, there are three different locates are available: English, Spanish, and French. Suppose user has first create, by default, the English is selected. So you are finding like name and age, two labels. And suppose user has clicked the or selected the Spanish. So if you see in the next image, second image, the name and age, both keywords are converted from English to Spanish. So whatever the location or localization you are selecting, your text or keywords are converted in that location. So for adding this, there are different properties like global dot properties, where if you are going for Spanish, so you have to use global underscore ES. ES is for Spanish. Like for France, it is global underscore FI dot properties. So what location you want? So for every location, some keyword is provided, some key value pair is provided for that. Next is exception handling. Suppose you want that if any exception is the STIRPS should handle the exception and redirect the user to a decided error page. It is possible. Example, here we have created one file error.jsp where a simple error message is we have just printed, and you have to configure this error.jsp file in our main STIRPS configuration file, that is STIRPS.xml. So here in a result tag, we are adding the name as error, and it will going to open the error.jsp file. So this file is an error.jsp. So whenever any exception is, uncaught exception is, or error is coming, it will automatically going to redirect the page to the error.jsp. The next is a annotation. Annotation is the extra information about any web page or anything. So annotation is also a part of Java, and STIRPS uses the annotation for basically a reason. Like first, we know that STIRPS.xml file is used for storing all kind of configuration. You will find all kind of configuration of any web page created in STIRPS2 in STIRPS.xml file. Suppose you don't want to use a STIRPS.xml file, then another way of configuring STIRPS2 is by using a Java annotation feature. There are different annotation type, like namespace annotation, result annotation, results annotation when you have more than one result, after annotation, this is one kind of interceptor annotation, before annotation, email validator annotation, when you want to validate an email text box, an automatic validation should be done. In-range field validator, if any text in any text box you want, user should enter only integer value with some specified range. The next is a required field validation, where a field is checked that it should not be empty. So there are different annotations which are available. This is a simple example. Like here, if you see @ required validator, so it is attached with the name field, and the message we will going to provide is that the name is required, means the name field cannot be empty. Now second field is age, and we have added annotation as int range field validator, where we are providing a message that it only going to accept the integer value, and the value should be between 28 and 65. So the minimum value is 28 and max value is 65. So likewise, you can create a different annotation. Thank you so much for watching this video.